Mir Jumla was a self-made man from a pre-humble background. He was born Mir Muhammad Said Ardistani in 1591 CE in a small place in Ardistani in Persia to a poor oil merchant named Mirza Hazaru. In 1660 CE, Mir Jumla was around 69 years old when he came to Bengal as governor. Soon after taking office, Mir Jumla started a large number of construction activities in Dhaka. He built two roads, two bridges, and a network of forts. The Mir Jumla Gates of Dhaka, the city remains of has bridge and a canon named Bibi Mariam, can be found in Dhaka even today and are the reminders of his rule. Aurangzeb appointed Jumla as the governor of Bengal. Along with this massive construction work, Mir Jumla also began to expand Mughal dominance in the east. He invited the Kush kingdom of Kush Bihar and forced the Raja of Kush Bihar to submit to Mughal authority. He gave explicit orders to Mughal soldiers that common people must not be harassed or located in any way. In 662 CE, Mir Jumla proceeded to invade the Ahom kingdom. Thakurunbari lies on the Meghalaya-Assam border about 8 kilometers from Ampati. The history has its date. Mir Jumla, who was appointed the governor of Bengal in 1659 by Mughal Emperor Aurangzeb, invaded Assam heading a vast army. Assam and even the Mughal Empire, he is also said to have been the man who gave the Kohinoor diamond to Shah Jahan and would go on to back the right as Aurangzeb monitor in the war of succession. At the same time, he ran a huge business empire that spans from Persia in the east. To Burma or Myanmar in the west. Here is the story of an extraordinary man who lives in an extraordinary time. In times, India was the place to be for youngsters across Persia and Central Asia. Mir Jumla arrives in Golconda, sometimes between 1615 to 1625 CE, and started working as a clerk at the office of a local diamond merchant. Golconda is where Mir Jumla lucky sense in the 17th century CE. Golconda was the diamond capital of the world, and merchants from all over the world come here to trade in this stone. Jumla started his independent diamond trade and became a wealthy diamond merchant. Mir Jumla proceeded to invade the Ahom kingdom of Assam. But ironically, this last campaign of Mir Jumla's life turned out to be a disaster. Mughal soldiers had to fight in very difficult terrain and suffer heavy loss. Supplies ran out and many lives were lost. Mir Jumla lost 2/3 of his army and they had to retreat. On his way back from Assam, he became extremely sick and passed away on a boat on 13 March 1663 CE. He was 72 years old when he died. He was buried on a hillock in Thakurumbari in present day South West Garo Hills district near the Assam-Meghalaya border, where his grave still stands.